Hey everybody, I'm Blue18 here, and I'm going the wrong way. Welcome back to Let's Play. last episode, I cut out a huge section of me, time traveling, because I was planning to go get the last Deku Nut upgrade, and, because as you can see, we only have 30. The last upgrade is 40, as you get 40. So many stomach noises and hiccups. Okay, the reason I couldn't get it is I went there with the Mask of Truth, put it on, went to the stage, hit me, went back, and dropped rupees. So I did some spelunking on the interwebs, and I found out that you can only get it as a kid before you... I'm just showing you here that you can... this is in post-commentary, by the way. I'm showing you that if you have the silver gauntlets, you can pick up these rocks, but I have the gold gauntlets now, so I can pick them up anyway. I think it's pretty cool. Like, let's see if I can pick one up. See if I can go, like, this way. I don't know. Let's pick it up from the side so you can kind of see Link there. And you can't really do anything. You can't change the camera either, so. Anyway, you can only get it as a kid before you pull the Master Sword. So, if you're playing this along with me, I'm sorry. At this point, you can't go get them. But I will put an annotation... In the video after I beat Jabu Jabu, before I pull the Master Sword, explaining that you should go back to Forest Stage with the mask and get that if you're planning on 100%ing this. But anyway, this is the fairy fountain that we came to as a kid. That we came to as a kid to get Din's Fire by bombing the rock. And as an adult, we need the gold gauntlets to... The gold gauntlets to lift that black pillar. And here, we will get our final Great Fairy upgrade, which is actually very beneficial, especially if you're playing a three-heart run. So it says, "Welcome, Link. I'm the Great Fairy of Courage. I'm going to enhance your defensive power. Receive it now." Yes, so the Great Fairy of Magic magically turned into the Great Fairy of Courage, and she's going to increase our defensive power. And what that means is that she's actually going to double our life energy. As she said, we are more defensive in the fact that we can take more hits now. Damage inflicted by enemies will be reduced by half. We have 20 heart containers total, but now with this upgrade, it essentially is 40. So this upgrade will make you have 40 heart containers, in a sense. If you're doing a 3-heart run, this is actually really cool to grab, because then you'll go from 3 to 6. It's not as big of a difference if you're doing a 3-heart run, but it does make some difference. But for me, since I have all of the heart containers, it makes a huge difference that we have double defense now. So now we are actually going to head into the bulk of Ganon's Tower, or Ganon's Castle. I usually call it Ganon's Tower. I don't know why. I think it's because I'm still hooked on Oracle of Ages. The Oracle games, I don't know if I've stated this before, I'm pretty sure I have, but the two Oracle games are by far my favorite of the games in the series, and I can't put one above the other because they were released as a pair, but they are my favorite of the games. Let's see, is he going to come down at me? Yeah, what up, Fire Bat? Oh, there's a whole bunch of them, God. Oh, Jesus, kill them all. Okay, arrows, please, thank you. Where did that other one go? There he is. Oh, lock on, Navi. Holy crap. I don't know what I did that I dropped a purple rupee. But that was weird. How many bats are in here? Do I even have to kill these bats? I just walked out of the room. I wish there was a map for this. Do I have to kill these bats, or can I just go? I can just go. Are you kidding me? I can just run up here. I don't even have to bother with these bats. Oh my god, I am so stupid. Yeah, but one of them dropped a purple ruby. That was really weird. Anyway, so there's two Dinofuls in here. I'm just going to go ahead and jump attack them. Two jump attacks with the big Goron sword. Pretty much, does it say Dinofuls? Yeah, it does. Come here. Oh, crap. Okay, seriously? Stop strafing and get over here. Alright. Door opens. Let's go. So, this part of the Ganon's Castle, Ganon's Tower, whatever you want to call it, is actually not too long. But there are the series of things. This is probably the most annoying of rooms, is the this part here. Look, oh, I trapped him up against the wall. Can I? I'm gonna slash him. There we go. I actually really never use the side slash a whole lot. I don't know if it's if you have to click the button to the side to do the side slash. But I guess you can. I totally missed him there. There we go. Kill the two Stealthos, and wouldn't you know it, it's actually a boss key. I thought this was really cool. You don't get a compass or a map for this place, but you do have to obtain a boss key, and you don't have to really look for it. It just kind of puts it there for you to grab. So yeah, that's actually really cool. I also like this whole like ascending staircases in between these rooms. I thought that was really cool. So in here, there's two Iron Knuckles. I'm gonna go ahead and see if I can just shoot an arrow at one of them and make him come at me. There we go. I like to take these on just one at a time. That way, they're not both coming at you. Let's go ahead and do that. Back off. Jump again. Back off. Jump again. And he's gonna come at you. Last jump, and he's gone. So come over here. This is a black. Aw, you fucker. You would hit me. Oh, this one dropped hearts, though, so that's not bad. Lock on. Jump. Oh, come on. Seriously? Okay. Okay, hold on. Well, it doesn't matter. This is going to make his armor fall off, and I can just jump back quick. There we go. They both take the same amount of hits, even though one's black and one's white, so. Alright. Oh, he did drop hearts. Nice. Thank you. I appreciate that. I need arrows. I should have stocked up on arrows before I came in here. There might be a restock room somewhere up here. I don't remember. Anyway, so this is the boss door. Let's go ahead and head on in. And, well, there's no boss, so that's kind of a shame. Ooh, yay. Pots. Pots. Arrows, please? Arrows? Oh, yes. Arrows. Oh, good. I needed arrows. Ooh, heart. Heart. Hearts. Arrows. Okay, that should be good. There's one more heart down here. 41 arrows should be good. I just didn't want to go in with only 11 arrows. That just didn't seem right. Alright. Ooh, a red carpet. Is this the Grammys? I like red carpets. Red carpet, red shield, red tunic. It's very cool. And this is actually the hall, or the swivelly staircase leading up to the final boss of the game, Ganon. For this part, I'm actually going to go ahead and switch back to the Master Sword. I didn't want to cut the door. Since what we're going to be doing next is actually easier with the Master Sword. I don't want to waste any of my potions or anything, and I actually got a fairy off camera. I don't know if you like caught it in between that I had a fairy in a bottle. But what we're going to be doing, I'm going to want the Master Sword because it swings a little better. So, plus, it's kind of more right that you're using the Master Sword to defeat Ganon. Dorf. So, anyway, so we got the Triforce of Power, of Courage, and the Triforce of Wisdom. And the man playing the... Ooh, we got our hearts filled up. Well, I didn't really need that, but thanks. The man playing the piano. The Triforce parts are resonating. They're combining into one again. What is a soul resonance? Are we doing a resonance link? The two Triforce parts that I could not capture on that day 7 years ago. I didn't expect they would be hidden within you two. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. Oh boy. And now, finally, all the Triforce parts have gathered here. His epic cape. These toys are too much for you. I command you to return them to me. Oh, crap. He's using a purple vortex. Link, I can't help you. Because of the waves of darkness, I can't get close. I'm sorry, Link. Yeah, you better be sorry. Anyway, so this is Great King of Evil Ganondorf. First thing you're going to do... Oh, crap. Don't make me fall. Okay, thank you. First thing you're going to want to do is get over here, get your sword out, and... fail. Great job, Link. Get your sword out, and just like with Phantom Ganon, we're going to go ahead and play some volleyball. Hold on, wait. This is really stupid to do this in the middle of the animation, but you're going to want to have your light arrows ready. Crap. Yeah, you don't want to lock... because you can't lock onto him. This is totally just Link going on here. So get back. Come on. Oh, seriously. Come on, I suck at this. See, the thing is, I always use the bottle to do this, and there are videos of people doing it with the bottle. So, if you want to see that, go ahead and do that. But otherwise, you do it with the sword. Now, if you're using the Master Sword, it takes a little longer. Go ahead. Oh, geez, so much slowdown from the N64. Oh, I don't have my sword out. Go ahead, get up here, and slash it, and then get over back onto the platform. I always suggest hanging out in the corner. That way you can have a good equal shot against him. The other thing with being in the corner is that you're going to have to... crap, I missed again! Seriously, oh my god. Stop laughing at me, it's not my fault. There we go. Oh crap, that's not what I wanted. Hit him. Oh crap, I missed. Jeez. Yeah, if you use your spin attack, it actually like speeds it up really fast. There we go. Alright, then hit him with an arrow. So much slowdown! I'm not even slashing him, I'm like standing behind him. Jeez. That was funny. If you fall down to the bottom, he will actually like break apart the platforms on the thing. Alright, get your sword out, jump over here, jump attack. Oh come on. Alright, fine, just hit him this way. Alright, can't get him. Alright, get back over here. I can't believe I'm doing this. Alright, let's get a slash attack ready. Huzzah! Ooh, he's vicious now. Alright, this should be the last time I have to hit him. In the face, get your sword out. Oh, he's getting zapped. Jump over here. Hit him. Come on. Seriously? Crap, I might have to actually use my green potion. Alright, this time I think I'm... Okay, with this, when he's doing that, just go ahead and... shoot him with the arrow while he's always like gaining or absorbing his power. Just come over and slash him. Come on, slash him, kill him, please kill him. Oh my gosh, seriously. Okay, well I guess I can show the bottle trick then, since I'm gonna have to restore my magic. Let's go ahead and yes, bring a green or blue potions with you because you will need them. Anyway, so with this, go ahead and get your bottle out. Oh, he's gonna do this again. Oh, okay. That works for me. Let's go ahead and do that. Oh, way to miss, Link. All right, come over here. If he does that, if he does the orb thing again, I'll go ahead and show how another way you can do it. Okay, hold on. Ah, I totally failed. I was doing so good before with the spin attacks. What are you gonna do now? What do you do? Okay, so here with this orb, go ahead and get a charge attack ready. He fires all the orbs. Let loose your spin. Oh, did I get them all? And then hit him with an arrow. That's kind of the harder way to do it. But it's still good to do it that way. I like doing it that way. Oh my gosh, this guy's taking forever. Jeez. I was sure by now I would have got him. Alright, cool. I like just doing it this way, though. Ka-ching! Get him while he's not, paying attention. He's charging his attack. There we go, we got him. Oh yeah. The great evil King Ganondorf. Beaten by this kid? Oh man, no way! Oh, I have an OC! I have an original cartridge. This is the moment I was waiting for. I was not sure if I was going to have a 1-0 or a 1-1 cartridge. And this proves it all. I have a 1-0 cartridge. This means that it's not the gold cartridge, but this is the post-original release cartridge that it's gray, but it still has the same game coding, and Ganondorf still has red blood, which is pretty cool. Oh, man, I totally am so psyched about that. So psyched. Oh, that is so badass. The whole meaning of this LP just got so much better. See, and I had to make the decision if I was going to play this on the VC or on the actual N64. And I decided N64. I'm just going to skip this text because it's unimportant. And I decided N64. One, because I'm more used to the N64 controls from when I was younger, and it's just a little easier to do. Whereas the GameCube controls are a little more touchy, and the control stick is so much more sensitive. So it wasn't as good. It was just as good, but the controls were like a little off, especially with how touchy the control stick was. Alright, so now we have to traverse down the outside of the castle as it's collapsing. If you get hit with a boulder, Zelda will like freak out. That's not the bottom. Stupid Link. Anyway, so you can't get through these bars, so you have to have Zelda come down and use her arms to open the door. And as to reference, skinny ass arms. But anyway, this is, if you fall down during that other fight, you'll end up here, and you'll just have to hookshot back to the top. I don't know if I could do that while she's, getting her ass over here. Anyway, you can, like, hookshot almost all the way up to the top, so I'll just go ahead. Did I not grab it? No, maybe not. Where is she? Seriously, where's Zelda? Zelda? Where are you? I was just over there, and you weren't there. What's wrong with you? She was like, you were playing with your hookshot. And I was like, of course I'm playing with my hookshot here, because you're useless. Anyway, jump! And come down this way. There's another jump that you make when you come out of a door. It's a little more dumb, but it's not terribly bad. You just kind of have to like watch out when you jump, because otherwise you're going to fall down to the bottom. So you come into this room. Watch out for the boulders. The boulders! The boulder disapproves! So they give you plenty of time to get out of here. Anyway, it's I think it's this platform right here. Yeah, this platform right here. Be careful when you first come out. You don't jump off the side, because like you'll jump off and they're like, oh god, I just fell down to the bottom of Ganon's cower. So, did I say Ganon's cower? Ganon's castle tower. Anyway, come in here. Zelda's gonna get. Well, you have to go like try to talk to her. She's gonna get trapped in fire. And big meanies. What a big meanie. The blue meanies. Actually, you know what? Screw this. I'm gonna switch back to Big Goron. Yeah. Shazam! I gotta save my girl. I'm not flipping around. Yeah, and the lag, that's like legit lag from the game. It's not slowed down or anything. Not at Egg Silver. That's actually happening. Bam! Get out of here, Skull. Anyway, she loves me, so she drops some hearts. Go ahead and pick those up and go through the door. Oh, look, I'm holding the bigger Ouran with one hand. Crazy. Do I still have it, like, out when I come out here? No. All right, go, Zelda. Hoop. I almost, like, land on her. He's like, I'm going to jump on your head. If you're wearing the hover boots for this, you won't actually jump. You'll just kind of, like, run off the side and then fall. So be careful. And don't get hit by stuff, because then she stops. She stops and worries about you. Oh, Zelda, why are you so worried? I'm not gonna die. I can't die. I'm the hero of time. Yeah, see, Alex, she stopped. Just go all the way to the bottom. She'll catch up eventually. Get down here. Bitch, make me a sandwich. Alright. Open the last door. And we can get out of here. Almost. Oh yeah, there's a Redead here. Redead is super annoying. Let's just slash his kneecaps. There we go, slash his kneecaps. Okay, I think this is the last door. I hope so. It better be. I said it was the last door of the last one. Yeah, this is the last door. Alright, dodge the debris. See, she like stopped. And she's like, oh my god, you're getting hurt! I'm like, I got 40 hearts, bitch! Get the sword all up in her face. Link's like, I'll put my sword in your face. Alright, we dash out of the castle. This is a really cool cutscene, actually. I like this. Bridges are falling off. Explosions are happening. Towers falling down. It's rumbling. There's a rumbling in my tumbling. There's a rumbling in my tummy. Rumble, rumble. Debris blowing off the door. See, it like starts falling sideways. You think it's going to fall over flat, but it doesn't. And it like internally collapses. The anti-gravity device has been destroyed. And now the tower is falling. I just love the way this like internally collapses. Just something about it, like every time I've played this and I finish the game, there's just always been something about it that it's like, oh man, that's so awesome. Oh, it's just like, it flattens out, you know. It's just so crazy. I don't know, something about it. I've always enjoyed seeing that. Anyway, and Ganon's castle is no more. Well, except for like that pile of rubble in the middle. That's right, it's finally over. Where to once again? And Navi. Aw, that's okay, Navi. I did pretty well on my own. Link's like, oh, what? What's happening? Perhaps we should investigate? I don't know. I mean, what do you think, Zelda? What is that sound? What's that sound? What's that sound? Big K Slammers!